Hello students, Abha Arora this side. I'm going to elaborate this article once again, potential due to an electric dipole. I hope after watching this video, your doubts and queries will be clear. So let us see, we have two lines, okay, R1 and R2. Both are inclined to each other at an angle and that angle is very, very small. As you can see, length R1 is not equal to length R2. So what we can do in this case, what we have to do, we have to draw a perpendicular from a shorter line to a longer one, such that after drawing perpendicular, see, from the point at which the perpendicular is drawn, both the lengths are equal and the left out will be difference of longer length minus shorter length. So whenever two lines are given to you and both are unequal in length, we can use this trick. We can draw a perpendicular from the shorter line to the longer one, and at the point of perpendicular, after that, what will happen? Both the lengths will be equal and the difference is what? R2 minus R1. Okay. So the same trick we have to use in our article, that is potential due to an electric dipole. Okay. So P is the observation point at which we want to find potential due to the dipole, and the dipole is plus charge Q is placed at a point A. It is at a distance R1 from point P, and negative charge is placed at point B, which is at a distance from P as R2. Center of the dipole is making an angle theta and also the distance is r. So what we have to do, see what I have done, from point A I have drawn a perpendicular which is AN on the line OP, because clearly you can see OP is longer as compared to AP. So after N point, what will happen? Both the lengths will be equal. So I can write AP equal to NP. What I can write? AP equals to NP. And students, how you can write NP? How you can write NP? NP can be written as OP minus ON. How NP can be written as OP minus ON? What is the length of AP? R1. What is the length of OP? R. How you can find ON? See, it is a right angle triangle. It is a right angle triangle. So given angle is theta, opposite side to given angle is always perpendicular. So AN will be your perpendicular. The side opposite to 90 degree is always hypotenuse. So OA is what? Hypotenuse. And the left out side, which is ON, is base. What you want in this right angle triangle? You want base. And what you know? You know hypotenuse, because we know total length of the dipole is how much? It is 2A. So OA will be how much? A. So hypotenuse is known to us, we want to find base. So which trigonometric ratio is connecting base and hypotenuse? Cos theta, cosine of angle, very good. So by using that, we can find out that ON is equal to A cos theta. So now I'm having expression of R1. R1 is how much? R minus A cos theta. I'm doing square on both sides. So after squaring, R1 square will be equal to R square plus a square cos square theta minus 2ar cos theta, but theta is small. So what you can do, cos square theta can be taken approximately equal to 1. So as theta is small, so cos square theta can be approximately taken 1. So what you can write, you are getting the final expression as r1 square equal to r square plus a square minus 2ar cos theta. Okay, so this was about R1 square. Similarly, how to find R2? What we can do now, I have extended this OP up to a point N dash. What I have done, I have extended this OP up to a point N dash. Okay, so I have drawn a perpendicular from B to this line OP after extension, and that perpendicular is BN dash. Now both these lengths will be equal. Both these lengths will be equal. BP will be equal to N dash B. How you can break N dash B? N dash B can be broken as N dash O plus OP. How you can write OP? OP is R. What is the length of BP? It is R2. How you will find N dash O? Now, as you can see, these angles, they are vertically opposite. So if AOP is theta, similarly, N dash OB will also be theta. So again, you have theta, and this is a right angle triangle. So I don't think so it will be a difficult task for all of you to find N dash O. Similarly, N dash O will come out to be A cos theta. Now what you have to do? Do squares on both sides. So R2 square will be R square plus A square cos square theta plus 2AR cos theta. Again, theta is very, very small. So what will happen? Cos square theta can be approximately equal to 1. So we are getting our final expression. R2 square is equal to R square plus A square plus 2AR cos theta. I hope with the end of this video, it is clear to everyone how to write expression of R1 square and R2 square. Rest of the article is well explained and you can watch the video once again. But still, if you have any doubts and queries, then you can tell me in the comment section below. Thank you so much.